detail every single thing, building the rocket, launching it to space, getting to the moon, doing the landing. We're going to go over that. We're absolutely going to go over that. All right. Let's see here. We need to... More for the viewers. No, that's cool, Iconic. That's cool. I appreciate you. Let's go ahead and time warp here. And what I want to do is come over this way. Continue pointing retrograde. I'm going to need to slow down, right? I'm going to need to slow down. What I need to do is fast forward, time warp. And right now, what are we doing? We're actually falling down that arc, that ellipse, which is actually inside the planet, that curve, whatever term y'all want me to use. I do read my chat, even if it's not highlighted in red. Das is going to be so bad at missing the moon that he's going to lithobreak. You're exactly right. Hopefully it's just a little bit of lithobreaking, a couple meters per second. But see how we're falling down that arc, curve, ellipse, orbit, whatever you want to call it, going down towards the planet, moon. I keep saying planet. It's not a planet, it's a moon. And what I want to do, I think right up there looks like a good place. I'm going to land at the top of that crater. What I want to do is just keep on falling along. Look for that crater. Am I in the crater right now? Let's orient ourselves. Oh, we're not over the crater yet. All right. I'm just going to keep falling along towards the moon like this. And when I get to some place that I think I'm going to do that, I'm going to get rid of more velocity. In fact, I want to get rid of so much velocity. I'll show it to you in map screen right here. I want to get rid of so much velocity, I start to fall straight down. Let's see what that does. So right here, again, I'm pointing my rocket along the way that I'm going, right? Like that. I'm going to light the engine, and I'm going to get rid of more and more and more velocity. Because I don't want... I want to miss the planet a lot. I want to miss it even more than that. Even more than that. And the more I burn, the more I fall down. And the more I fall down, the less I miss the planet. And the less I miss the planet, the more likely it is that I'm actually going to land on the planet. See how that arc keeps coming in and coming in? It keeps coming in and coming in and coming in. And I'm just going to keep removing my velocity, just like this, until this stage is dead. There we go. Right there, I'm going to go ahead and ditch that stage. I don't need it anymore. And looky looky, what is that? Who knew that there was a lunar arch there? Maybe we should just go over there. I got rid of that stage. I've got this guy. Let's go ahead and put our gear down. And let's go over there and visit that lunar arch. What I'm going to do is just fly around. The landing's pretty simple. The landing's pretty simple. I am just falling backwards. Where is my retrograde? There's my retrograde right there. And all I need to do, that crater looks good. We'll leave that arch up there. We can go visit it later. What I'm going to do is just fly this craft such that it comes to a stop when it touches the surface of the moon. That's all you really have to do. You've got a lot of really good tools here just in the stock game. I'll show you what you can use in Kerbal Engineer. That thing's going to explode. I am just falling down towards it. And I'm going to use my engine to make sure that I don't crash into it. Let's land right on that edge there. Just continuing to do this. Pushing that green X. Pay attention to that green X because I am going to tell you all about how that green X works when we actually get into the landing. But it's not a big deal. I just did a couple burns. That other part crashed. We didn't need it anymore. And we're going to come straight down. Now, I don't want to hit the moon too fast. I'm coming down at 43 meters per second. So let's rectify that situation. I actually want to be coming down at less than 6 meters per second. So when I get here, I can just modulate my throttle. So I continue falling straight down, just like this. But when I hit, I don't want to hit at 18. I don't want to hit at 13. I don't want to hit at 10. There's my shadow. I don't want to not hit, though. I want to hit the planet moon. Right like that. And now we're landed on the moon. Congratulations, Lixnoba! I appreciate you for doing the first lunar landing. In fact, in memory of your lunar landing, I am going to go ahead... Wait, no, I want to toggle this thing. Extend. Right like that. Let's get the ladder down as well. Extend the ladder. Right like that. Excelente. That looks good. Lixnoba, get on out! Whoa! Who taught you that one, Niglu? Good job, cadet. Good job, cadet. Here's Lignoba successfully landed on the surface of the moon. And here is what we're going to do. I buy shirts on eBay. Everybody who thought that was easy, I'm going to teach you to do that. I'm going to do that landing 4 or 5 or 6 or 7 times over and over again in quick succession. And I'm going to explain every single thing I'm going to do. I'm going to pause the game. I'm going to show you what to look at. I'm going to show you how to do that same exact thing. Let's do this in honor of his first successful Mooner mission here at Kerbal Boot Camp Saturday. Kerbal Space Program, thank you so much. Let's plant a flag, and we are going to call it Boot Camp Giveaway Hype right there. Lignoba. Lignobas. Wait, Lignoba the not quite courageous. Courageous. Does it have an E in it? The not quite brave. Let's say Mooner landing of Lignoba the not quite brave. I put quite brave. Let's do not quite brave. Like that. Folks, let's do a giveaway. Let's do a giveaway. Right here in the channel, I believe. We've got somebody. Who? Crossover, if you're here, has donated. There, right there. Bam. Crossover. Crossover actually donated a copy of KSP for this so that we could give it away at boot camp. So I am going to... It's a Steam copy, right? It's a Steam gift that I will send to you via Steam. But we are going to have a raffle. It's the first raffle I've ever done. An entry, a giveaway sort of thing. If you want to get a copy of Kerbal Space Program, what you need to do is enter the raffle. It's going to cost you 10 credits. 10 credits. You can check your credits by pressing, by typing exclamation point credits. You see everybody doing it in chat. You earn credits by watching boot camp. If you've just showed up, you may not have enough to enter. Don't worry. We've got lots of giveaways we're going to do. Every time we reach a milestone, we've got lots of giveaways we're going to do. So, if you don't have enough credits right now, don't worry. We're going to have more credits. We're going to have more giveaways coming up. I've never done a giveaway before. I don't even know what to say. Raffle open 10-100 Kerbal Space Program. Ticket raffle for Kerbal Space Program open to all users. Each ticket costs 10 credits and you can buy a maximum of 100 tickets. Guys, if you want to enter into this, what do you type to enter? You actually type, I think it's ticket and the number of tickets you want to buy, if that's correct. Make sure... Wow, that chat spot. Oh my gosh, chat is off the chain. I'm never going to be able... Jeez. If you want to enter... There you go. Hectic. If you want to enter, do ticket. I'm going to actually pause my screen so you can see it. Look. Guys, I know it's scrolling really fast, but look over here. Look right here. If you want to enter, do exclamation point ticket X, where X is the number of tickets you buy. If you've got 10 credits... You can get one ticket. If you've got 20, you can get 20. If you want to save your credits and like get 100 tickets later on or whatever, you can do that. I don't think you'll get 100. But it's up to you if you want to enter or not. I am going to get myself a Raffle Hype Delicious Dr. Pepper, and then I am going to come back here. I don't know how to do a timer. So I'm just going to call it out. I'm going to give y'all 1 or 2 minutes. Not too long. Just a couple minutes here to get entered. Ticket Infinity. That's hilarious. Get entered if you want. If you want to enter, do Ticket X. Exclamation point Ticket X. X is the number of tickets you want to buy. Let me get myself a Dr. Pepper here while y'all get entered. Ah. I have a cooler full of Dr. Pepper, which is the first time I've done that. But anyways, this stream is not sponsored by Delicious Dr. Pepper. I've been drinking enough tea, and I want something real to drink. So I'm going to get some Delicious Dr. Pepper. Now the real question is, I should have caught up with the chat before I did the giveaway. Lignoba, good job, cadet. Good job. Look at that grin. Look at that grin, Lignoba. That is well done. That was absolutely a good job. I appreciate you being our volunteer, our randomly selected, I guess, cadet. yes, there we go. All right. Sure, okay, thank you, Yargnit, thank you. All right. Good to go, good to go. Let me drink some Dr. Pepper here. Get entered into the raffle if you want to get a copy of Kerbal Space Program, courtesy of one of our viewers. I appreciate it. Go ahead and get entered into the raffle. You do just what it says on the screen right there. If you want to enter, do ticket X. And you got a minute or two to go. I'm drinking some Dr. Pepper. I'm hanging out. We got the flag here. We've got the moon landing screensaver mode. Maybe a autographed Dr. Pepper. Nice. Let me see if anything else is going on here. Nice. All right, don't need anything there. Didn't miss anything there. You have 14. It's 10 per ticket. It's 10 per ticket. 25 tickets. You're not going to have enough for 25. This bot is going off. Yeah, F5 bot is starting to sweat. That's hilarious. That's absolutely hilarious. Yeah, Bugmints. I think that's cool. Yeah, Yargnet. Thank you, by the way. Thank you for that. I should do that. I should give away some Dr. Pepper on stream. I should totally give away some Dr. Pepper on stream. It's going to be easy to highlight the giveaways, I guess. Courageous, it has an E. Thank you, Jackson and Crossover, for showing me how to spell. Maybe I should not have did that spin. Maybe I should not have... Module exit for the win. He was totally dizzy when he got out of that module. He had no clue. You didn't fall over. I applaud. What's up, TNT Varo? Missed you. Was doing the landing. Make it look easy. Scarlet River! Welcome to Kerbal Bootcamp, Scarlet River. Thank you for dropping by. Thank you for dropping by. Raffle. There we go. We got it. And then raffle draw. Okay, so raffle close and raffle draw. T-raffle close, T-raffle draw. Thank you, Hectic. Thank you. Jackson, Das, you were really good. How long did it take you to become this good? That was a donation. Miklo. Miklo, 960 or 696. Thank you for that donation. I appreciate it. I really do appreciate the support. We're doing Kerbal Bootcamp. You're supporting the Academy by that doing that donation. Remember, folks, Kerbal Space Academy is brought to you courtesy of generous contributors, such as Miklo, who just gave a very generous donation. Folks, I really do appreciate it. Thank you for that, Miklo. It's awesome. That really is awesome. Hype, hype, hype for the donation. Ah, okay, Hectic. Ooh, Hectic, thank you for letting me say. Get you some sleep, man. I actually need to be on my way to start that giveaway. Copy-paste this. Let me make sure I got that off in another window so I can do it. Hectic, thank you so much for helping me get set up with that. It was very serendipitous that you appeared in my stream. There we go. And then it was raffle close and raffle draw. Okay, cool. You want to finish the raffle? Do raffle cold. Okay, good. Dude, Hectic, thank you for the help. I owe you one for that for sure. I definitely appreciate you. Dash, you're really good. Okay, we got that one. You got to get going. Thank you again, Hectic. This is a controversy. Is Moon or Minimus the best beginner planet? Rutnut, the Moon is easiest to get to. Minimus is easiest to land on. To answer Rutnut's question, this is a controversy. Is Moon or Minimus the best beginner planet? My answer would be the Moon is easier to get to. Minimus is easier to land on and take off of. Is that a Moon Haze Prutz pack? I don't know what that means. A kinesis. Moon Haze Prutz pack. I don't know what that means. So no, probably. Wow. Chat has scrolled off the chain. There was an autographed. I will do. One day I'll do an autographed Dr. Pepper. That sounds like a great idea. That is an absolutely great idea. You make me thirsty. Hi, Das. What's up? Progen Souls, welcome back. Godfather Bobo, what headset do you use? It is a Turtle Beach X31. It's actually an Xbox headset. That's why I've got this. Marty71, welcome, Marty71. Iconic Wick, let me open those links in a new window and I'll get them later. 23K total views, and right now we have 176 viewers. That's awesome. That's awesome. I never had a Dr. Pepper, so send me one. I'll do that. I will send. If I'm allowed to, I will send. I will send an autographed Dr. Pepper to somebody. That's hilarious. Das, if you watch on mobile, do you still get credits? Calvin Kuhlman, I don't know the answer to that. Oh my gosh. I don't know the answer to that. I think you do. I think you do. I'm not sure. High speed docking crashing. Credits. Kuhlman. Okay, you do, Jackson. Thank you, Jackson, for helping us out. F5bot is probably overheating. You only have 7. You'll have enough. You'll have enough. I'm watching Das's. Nasiab, we just started it. Nasiab, we just started it. Today, I just got the bot installed today. I'm gonna keep it here, so if you watch over time, you'll continue to earn credits. But I just got the bot installed for boot camp, so we could do these giveaways. You'll continue to earn them. You can stockpile them or whatever. But Nasiab, we did just start from scratch, and I'm gonna be streaming for 8 hours today, so you'll get plenty of credits. Don't worry about it. Okay, what else? May I already own KSP, but I'll go for Dr. Pepper. I think we're ready to draw. Hectic, if you need to get going, go for it, man. I think we need to get going. I think we've got all the entries. It's not the end of the stream. We're not even getting started yet, Xavier Smithy. Spent 4.5 hours bringing a recorded KSV stream that helped a lot. Nice, thanks, thanks the Icea. Dos Dr. Pepper will never sponsor you if you give them advertising for free. I know, right? It's like, why buy the cow if you mix them, if you get the milk for free? Skybotech, I know. I had it right there if you want to enter a ticket. All right. Yeah, I had it like that, and I had Hectic's message there highlight. I think we're good to go. I think it's time for us. Now it's scrolling. See, there we go. Credit to hour ratio, I think it's 12 credits per hour. It's a credit every 5 minutes, Shadowfan. A credit every 5 minutes. Let's do this. Let's do this. We are going to go ahead, and I think it's going to be T-Raffle. Let me see if I can do it. T-Raffle close. Right like that. Ticket raffle closed. 32 viewers entered with a total of 48 tickets entered. 32 viewers entered with a total of 48 tickets entered. That's cool. So we are going to go ahead. Good luck, everybody. I've never done this before. I think it's going to be T-Raffle draw, right? What did I put in text pad over there? T-Raffle draw. Here we go. Let's see here. Let's see what we've got. T-Raffle space draw. T-Raffle draw. Let's see who gets the first copy. Drumroll is right, right in Hell in a Handbasket. I believe I can fly. T-Raffle draw. Here we go. I'm going to press enter, and we will see who wins the raffle for the copy of Kerbal Space Realm. Courtesy of Crossover. Crossover, thank you again for that, man. I really do appreciate you. 3, 2, 1. Enter. Survey says, Druida Morgan, viewer. Druida Morgan, viewer, with a 4.2% chance to win. Druida Morgan, thank you so much for watching Kerbal Bootcamp. What you need to do, Druida Morgan, what you need to do is send me a message on Twitch with your Steam ID, and I will get that game sent to you, probably during the next break. But Druida Morgan, right there, Druida Morgan, if you can hear me, you need to send me a message on Twitch, and I will get that gifted to you on Steam. I need your Steam ID in order to send it over. WB Hokey, the... Oh, there we go. Nice. It's following the stream. Awesome. Since 28th of October. Thank you, Drita Morga, for the follow on the 28th of October. That is really cool how that works. Hokey, we just installed that today. It's a bot that allows us to do giveaways. You earn tickets, or sorry, you earn credits, Kerbal Space Academy credits, by watching and by participating in chat. If you get my back, if you save me, if you catch something that I didn't catch and you say it in chat, I will give you some additional like bonus credits. But by default, you get them. I think you get 12 credits every hour. It's one credit every 5 minutes. That's what we did so we could do some giveaways today and keep track. There'll be levels you can level up and that sort of stuff. I will give people credits for catching my back and that sort of stuff. I've been wanting to get that set up for a while, and we did get it set up for boot camp today. So welcome, Hokey. Welcome, and congratulations to Druida Morgan. Druida Morgan. Send me that Twitch message. We have a lot more. We have a lot more giveaways to do. Keep on watching boot camp. Keep on earning those credits for attending class, right? Attending boot camp class. And we will have more giveaways to do coming up in a little bit. Blue Bay, we landed on the moon. We landed on the moon. And I think what we're going to do... I think what we're going to do is leave old Lignoba here. Wait, Should we leave Lignoba here, or should we go on back home? Jackson with the follow as well. I actually need to get caught up on the followers. I need to figure out if I should leave this. Will do. Nice. Thank you, Druida Morgan. Am I pronouncing that right? Druida Morgan, or is it Druida Morgan? I don't know which one it is, but congratulations. All the mods. Fearsome Fish, just can you show all the mods you have in the folder, and it's fine. Just long enough for me to screenshot it. Fearsome Fish 24, let me see what I can do there. Boot camp, saves, KSP win, game data. Here we go, get ready, Fearsome Fish. Get ready, Fearsome Fish. Here are all the mods that I have. Here are all the mods that I have. Let me actually do this. Is that going to show them all? Yeah, that'll show them all. Wait a second. Yeah, that'll show them all, it looks like. Alright. Alright, here's what we're going to do. We are going to click over here. That's not it. That's not it. This is not it. Where is my window? There it is. Okay. We're going to go... You ready, Fearsome Fish? Monitor capture. There we go. Here are all the mods that I have. Blizzy's Toolbar. This right here is going to be Ambient Light Adjustment. Boulder Co. is some of the environmental stuff. Crew Manifest, so we can name Kerbals. Eve is there. That's the clouds and stuff. Goodspeed is a fuel balancer. Image Viewer is something I use to display images. Kerbal Engineer, of course. That's Cybertech. Thank you, Cybertech. KSA, that's the Dr. Pepper tank. NASA Mission, it's not really a mod. Navball Mocking Alignment Indicator. Nav HUD, Notes, Precise Node, RCS Build Aid. Squad is not a mod. Stage Recovery, Trajectories, and Trigger Tech. Those are the mods I have. If you're interested in that, you can totally just screenshot that right there. But we are good to go. We are good to go. Hope you got it. If you haven't got it by now, I'm going to go ahead and close it down. But those are all the mods that I have installed in this save right there. There we go. All right. Let me minimize that back down. We've got this guy. Good stream. Had to follow to see more KSP. Thank you for that. Thank you for that. Fearsome Fish, hope you got that. Well, Dustin, need to sleep. Get some sleep, LADV. I'm not going anywhere. You can stay in the channel. You actually earn credits if you stay in the channel. You will earn credits in the channel. What are the accessible bot commands? TeslaMax, I don't know. What does the flag represent? It's just an icon. I'm actually looking for an awesome, kind of almost professionally designed KSA flag. Not in this. This is a Mercedes. You shot my hair. What are you even talking about? Drita Morgan, thank you for that. Thank you for sending the message. If two parts of your plane survive, you're landing on the runway. Is it a successful landing? Sure, Blipman. Sure, I'll allow it. I'll allow it. Let's do this. Let's do this. Actually, let's go over here. Let's look at this. You know something? I'm not going to put giveaways in the channel title. I'm not. I appreciate y'all being here because you want to come to boot camp. I don't want people to just come to the channel just because they want it. I want to stick it to the people who are actually interested in KSP, so I'm not going to put that there. I was going to do it, but I decided not to. All right, Lignoba. Well done. Let's get you one last screenshot. There you go. Let's get you back in the rocket and let's assess the situation and see what we can do here. Grab it. Crawl up. And press F to get inside. Go retract ladder. Like that. And let's see what we've got. We've got 2,000 meters per second of delta V. 2,000 meters per second of delta V. Wait a second, let's do this. Hang on. Me, chat, beacon. There we go. Oh, wow, that was the wrong one. Yeah, Scarlet. I want it to be people who are interested in KSP, not just people who want free stuff. That's what we're gonna do. We want to support people who want to play KSP. We don't want just random people to come over here. I would rather give it to a viewer than somebody who just wants to come here. Let's do this. I've got 2,000 meters per second of delta V. I used the wrong slash. Sorry. The arch. Remember. Let's do this. Let's get old Lignoba home. Let's get Lignoba home. Then we're gonna talk about how we built that rocket. We're gonna talk about the basics of KSP, thrust to weight. Delta V, what all those things mean, how to get into orbit, how to do launches, all the commands that we used, how to get to the moon, how to do this landing. I'm going to walk you through it a step at a time, and we're going to keep doing those giveaways as we accomplish the milestones. So, the arch is that way, isn't it? Yeah, there's the arch. Okay, I just had to locate it because it was just over the horizon. Lignoba, good job on your landing. Let's get you home. I am going to go ahead and throttle up and take off. Dorsal side. You are going to hear me talk about dorsal side like there is no tomorrow. You are going to hear me talk about dorsal side a lot. Because I like dorsal side. Whenever I talk about knowing the dorsal side of my craft, it means that I am able to predict what's going to happen on the screen based on the buttons I press. Check this out. If I press D, I know I'm going to go to the left. If I press A, I know I'm going to go to the right. If I press W, I know I'm going to pitch down. If I press S, I know I'm going to pitch up. E's going to roll me right. Q's going to roll me left. Why does that work? Why does that work? That works because I have this craft oriented right now such that the dorsal side is pointing up. The dorsal side is pointing up. That is what allows you to keep your control orientation throughout your flying of your craft. If I was sideways like this, look how confusing this is. If I was sideways and I pressed D, I actually pitched down. That doesn't make any sense. When I'm in a flight simulator and I press D, I expect myself to move that way, right? To move to the right. I don't expect myself to go down. I need to put the craft dorsal side up. Actually, so the hatch is up just like that, right? And when I do that, pressing D moves me in the right direction. It gets even more confusing when you're upside down and around like this. Like, what button do I press right now if I want to pitch up a little bit, right? What button do I press? Is it Q? No, it's not going to be that. Is it A? That's going to pitch me down. W is going to pitch me the wrong way. I'm actually going to need to press D if I want to pitch up. If I fly the craft like this, with the hatch, the dorsal side up and facing away from me. Oops, missed it just a little bit there. If I fly the craft like that, with the dorsal side up and facing away from me, I can predict what the different commands are going to do. Why did I turn RCS on? Here's the Moon or Arch, by the way. If you didn't know, there's actually a couple different... a couple different ways for this to work. I am just going to go ahead and explore, somebody said, the Moon or Arch. I don't know if y'all know what that means, but this is how I explore the Moon or Arch. Not showing off or anything. Let's go ahead and get on back home. That was through the Moon or Arch, and I need to burn this way to get into orbit. Silly DOS. That looks good. Let's go ahead and bring those landing gear up. Good piloting, by the way, good Lignoba. Good piloting. Actually, don't let him know we did not have his controls activated there. That was all computer control by mission control. Back there. We can land on the arch. I want to keep it going. Maybe we'll take something else out of here and land on it. I am going to go home now. I am going to go home. And first step to getting home is to get into orbit. Not necessarily, but for now, we're going to do this. Shh, don't tell Lignoba that his controls weren't doing anything. He was like, look at me, I'm flying the craft. He's all pressing buttons and doing the throttle and stuff, and it wasn't doing anything. Mission control was in control of that. Good job, though, Lignoba, on the amusement ride that is your Moon or mission here. Keep on pressing them buttons. Anyways, I've got myself up here. Remember what we did to get into orbit? I'm just going to put a node there. I'm going to add maneuver, and I'm going to pull it prograde until we get a periapse. That's 6,000 by 12,000. Let's pull it some more. 11,000 by something. 15,000. That's good enough for getting home. Let's go there. Again, 22-second burn. It says it right down there. Node in T-minus 35. This is my node indicator. I need to point right there. And when I get to T-minus half of this, I need to do the burn. Cybertech, don't fret. I haven't forgot about you. 11 seconds is half of 22. When it gets to T-minus 11, that's when I'm going to do the burn. Drink some Dr. Pepper, by the way. It's like lip syncing. Lignoba isn't lip syncing. He is lip rocketing. He thinks that he's doing it, but he's not actually doing it. He's just going through the motions in mission control. He's going to like lose connectivity to mission control or something, and he's going to be pressing buttons and nothing's going to be happening. Good times. Good times. All right, there we go. Bing, right like that. 13 by 8, that's good enough to get us home. Let's go and plot a course for home. Oh, wow. We could have just kept burning and we would have gone home. Anyways, whenever I get home, here's what I want to do. I want to set a node somewhere over here. Do you see Kerbin over there? Do you see the moon prograde? This is the way. The moon, if you look at Kerbin in the background, the moon orbits to the right, just like that. This is retrograde, it's called. This is prograde. What I want to do is find this slice that is, where's Kerbin? There we go. Between Kerbin and the prograde of the orbit. So you see Kerbin right there. Am I orbiting the right way? Yeah, I am. between Kerbin and the prograde. This is only if you're orbiting in the correct direction. Go ahead and put a node anywhere back here, add maneuver, and burn it prograde. And what I want you to do is pull that node prograde until it looks like that. Do you see how that line is going kind of parallel? Not exactly parallel, because this is a curve and this is another more different curve. A curve and another more different curve. Consummate! I said consummate! You want to set it up so that this node burns prograde and ends up with a line like this. If I look at Kerbin, that line should be pointing to the left. That is retrograde to the moon's orbit. To the left like that. That is going to get me home. That right there is an periapse of 120. Let's actually get all the way down. Now we're just going to play with it. Let's put some more delta V in it. Let's move it around a little bit. What's our periapse? 746. Let's put some more delta V in it. Periapse is now 212. Let's put some more delta V in it. Periapse is 32. That's actually in the atmosphere. So now we can actually just move it around a little bit. That's down to 22. That is definitely us coming home. That is definitely us coming home. Why doesn't he go to Minmus? I do go to Minmus, but at boot camp I use the moon. It's the easiest place to get to. Minmus is definitely easier to land on, and we do all of our Kerbal Space Academy landing drills on Minmus. But this one's a little bit easier to get to. You just point at it and burn. So that right there, when we burn this node, it's going to take us down to Kerbin, 22960. Why chat? Why chat am I good to go if I am at a periapse of 23K? Can anybody tell me why that means that I'm good to go? Let me do that. There we go. Why? Why is that good to go right there? I'm not at home yet. I'm not in orbit. Why does that look good? Why does that look good? Tylo landing drills. Yargnet, you're hilarious, Yargnet. Tylo landing drills. We are going to do a Tylo return mission one day. It's not going to be today at boot camp. That's not where we send our new recruits, right? Our boots. But why are we good to go? Because science. Aerobraking. EPD's got it. EPD was the first one there. Hey, somebody. Actually, could I do that? Could I, wait, can I do this? Can I add E underscore P E T T E Y 2005, right? 2005. Is this going to work? Is that going to work, or do I have to do it the other way? I don't know how to do it. I really don't know how to do it. Throw them in the fire, let them sink. I don't think that's right. Gav, do you know the command for this? Watch, I'm not a level 2 moderator or something. Can you do the command for that, Gav? Did you see what it was when, add 5 EPD? That can't be right. I don't know the command, but EPD needs 5 credits. Yeah, oh, there we go, added 5, okay. New balance, 35. EPD, good job. Thanks for asking the question. I appreciate you. I appreciate you. All right. We're good to go. This is going to be a 13-second burn coming up in 24 minutes. Let's go ahead and do that. Congratulations, EPD. You earned some you earned yourself some extra KSA credit for answering that question. Maybe I should start doing that. So let's go ahead on down. Half of 13 is kind of the same as half of 14, right? 7. So when I get down to T-minus 7 seconds, I am going to do this burn. If you're using BTTV, you can type the start of somebody's name and press tab, and it'll auto-complete it for you. I'm not using BTTV. I'm using the chatbot or the chatty program for my commands and stuff. But that makes sense. You can type the start of somebody's name, like. Oh, you can do it over there as well. Wow. Okay, I can just press tab and it'll complete it. Nice. Not getting your vid for a while, really? You might try to refresh or something. Guys, the credits that you're earning for attending Kerbal Bootcamp can be used in giveaways. We're actually giving away some copies of Kerbal Space Program today. And the credits that you're earning just for watching are going to be used in those giveaways. You can also get bonus credits. You can get extra credits at the Academy by answering questions like that whenever I ask them. Chatty has that function too. Yeah, Arbramer, I just figured that out. Thank you. Thank you for that. KBC Pop Quiz. Yeah, you're right. It is. KPC. KSA pop quiz, really. That is really awesome to know. It works really well. Because you'll become all flamey and fall out of the sky. Sir Curl, I liked your answer too, because you can use that drag. In fact, yeah, we'll do that. We'll do the most complete answer, because you can use that drag to slow down. I like that. I like that. Arrow breaking was the quick answer. Will these credits roll over Pale Rider? I think so. I haven't really thought too much about that yet, but I think they will. I think they will. What if you already have buttery KSP DOS? Give it to a friend, I guess. I really thought about that, and I I don't know. I really don't know what else to do. I will definitely, if somebody wins who already has it, I will definitely give that a good think and see if there's something that I can do beyond KSP. I don't know. Chatty has that function also. Yeah, cool. Alright, so this is going to come up in 7 seconds. T-minus 7 seconds. 40, 30, 20, 25. And I'm just going to, again, burn towards the node marker. There's Kerbin. Here we are. We're just going to burn right like this. You know what I want to try one day? Can I get back to Kerbin by burning at Kerbin? Like, when Kerbin rises, could I get back to Kerbin by burning at Kerbin? That's an interesting thought. I don't know. Anyways, let's just go ahead and continue flying this rocket, just like this. We're going to burn that node out, pointing at the blue thing. And we are going to kill it right like this. Bink! Like that. That should get us home. Let's go check. Periaps of 48. Burn more. 40, 30, 20. 19. That looks good. That looks good. Using multiple tabs. Nice. Thank you, Brimmer. I appreciate you. I did not know those things, but that is an excellent thing to know. And now you can see that our actual trajectory is ejecting us from the moon. It's called ejecting yourself retrograde from the moon's orbit. Roughly. But that is going to do two things. It's not only going to get us away from the moon, it's going to decrease our velocity relative to Kerbin. We'll talk more about that in depth. But what we're doing, ejecting retrograde to the moon, is the same as pointing an engine retrograde and taking energy out of your orbit. It's two birds with one stone. It is getting away from the moon and decreasing your velocity relative to Kerbin such that you fall down and crash and die. Hopefully not. We'll see. It depends on how Lignoba behaves on the way home. But let's just go ahead and time warp now. And we are going to say goodbye to the moon. Goodbye, moon. Lignoba, wave goodbye. There goes the moon. Let's go back to the map view. Watch what's going to happen here. You see two orbits. Somebody asked me the different colors. The blue line is the orbit you are currently on in the sphere of influence that you're currently on. So that means right now the moon is being used to compute our gravitational pull, and we are currently going to follow that blue line until we get to here, which is the moon escape. When we get to the moon escape, we're actually going to transfer over here to this tan orbit. That is the next orbit that we are going to go on. So when we do this transfer, this tan one will become blue, and our ship, this will actually disappear. When we exit the moon's sphere of influence, where the moon's gravity is actually being used to compute us, what we are going to do is begin computing ourselves relative to Kerbin. When we do that, the orbit colors will change. This orbit will become blue, right like that. Come on. Right like that. It bumps like that sometimes. And now the orbit we are currently on is like this. If I put a node down here and I add a maneuver, that orange or the tan orbit, that would be our orbit if we resulted the maneuver. Now, if you get into situations where you've got multiple things, multiple orbits, they can go into different colors like red and purple and that sort of stuff. And when I get some of those, I will do that. I will definitely do that. No, Mr. Bond, I expect you to play a 2-liter train. What? Will the credits be on our channel? Musical Tanks, yes, right here on my channel. That's where I am, right? I'm not broadcasting on KSP. No, I'm on my channel. Make me worry for a second. Is Help Desk tomorrow? Pay Rider. Help Desk is absolutely tomorrow, Pay Rider. Absolutely tomorrow. Doss, since the goo material cellular single use was the easiest way to collect science on the go. Mercenary Blue, you need to look up my Farming Science on Minmus YouTube video. Farming Science on Minmus. I'll put a link right here for you. Info. If you go to YouTube, you can look at Farming Science on Minmus, and you will see, since their one use, what the fastest way to collect science is. You can scrape the entire surface of Minmus in one launch. In one launch. Have you explained what two buttons do on the maneuver nodes? I saw you hit a button and it advanced you a full orbit. Snake of Fusil! Yes, I can definitely show you that. We're not going to need it to go to the moon, but I will definitely figure out a way to show you what those weight in orbit and unweight in orbit buttons do. Snake of Fusil, thank you for asking that question. That's a good one right there. I was just answering this right here. Eltos, what's going on? Or Lieutenant Haas? There was that one. Alright, so I got that one. When you build the rocket, you're just going to use the demo parts. Silverstein, when I build the rocket, I'm just going to use stock parts. Stock parts. We've already done Smoke 'em. Every Thursday, I learn a new mod. And we actually did advanced parts, advanced space plane design last night. So it just varies. Today is definitely boot camp day. We don't go into the advanced topics today. Today is the day that we show new players or people who haven't played it much or people who have just interest in the game, just watching, right, that this game is totally awesome and they can play it. So today is all basic concepts, right? But we do other streams where we've got a... Yeah, there we go. Gab's got my back too. We do other streams where we have that information done. Desktop. There we go. Let me fix this. Bot commands. Save. All right, now I've got that. It won't blow up. Gav, it's okay. It's okay. I know you've got some stream delay. I'm back, and this show is for me. That is good to hear. The good news is, folks, while I was running my mouth, I was also time warping, and here comes Kerbin. What we're going to do, we're going to fall down to Kerbin, and it's going to stop my time warp. Whoa, do you see it slow down the time warp? Real solar system. No, I'm not. It's going to be a long time before I do real solar system. I'm honestly not a big fan of real solar system. I don't really see a reason to spend more time doing the same stuff. It's kind of cool to have the actual planets in there, I guess, if you've got the actual Earth solar system planets. But I'm never going to use scaling or anything like that in my Kerbal Space Academy streams because I don't want to just take more time to teach the same concepts. You know what I mean? I will give it a look one day, but I'm not going to use it particularly ever to stream Academy sessions because it really just adds time to the stream, I think, and I don't think we need to do that. Das does stuff that can be done stop game without mods. He does have some mods. Dude, Cybertech. You look at Cybertech earning his keep, man. Thank you, Cybertech. That's so awesome. How do I prevent extremely high G-forces on re-entry? My Kerbals always die. You must have deadly re-entry, Blue Bay. Step one, uninstall a deadly re-entry. Step two, don't do this. Don't do this. Come in a lot shallower. But look at what's happening right now. As we get the shock heating, right? Partially due to friction and partially due to compression. As we do the shock heating here, we heat up just like this. Now, in the stock game, this isn't going to hurt you. In real life, you would die. These parts would start exploding. There's also a mod called Deadly Reentry, which simulates the shock heating of the atmosphere here, right? As we fly in the stock game, it looks pretty. But it's actually not going to hurt you. If you install Deadly Reentry, it will in fact make you explode. But Cybertech does deserve some credits. Wait a second. What's he going to do with them, though? I don't know. Yeah, he deserves some credits. I don't know what he's going to do with them. Cybertech, do you need some credits? Do you have a copy of Kerbal Space Program? I'm not sure. But you see, as we come tearing through the atmosphere, our velocity is rapidly decreasing. I'm not actually burning the engines. That arrow breaking, the air at the atmosphere, the friction of the atmosphere is actually causing me to slow down a lot. An awful lot. He could give the game away to friends. Yeah, that makes fun. That makes sense. And fun. Whoa! That was loud. FL Kiwi, dude, appreciate you, Das. What are you trying to do? Make me land? Crash? Kill Lignova? Do you have something against Lignova, Kiwi? Thank you for the donation. I really do appreciate it. And again, the $10 donation is what I would get from Twitch in 4 months. So that's like subscribing to me for 4 months on Twitch if I had subscriber status or partner status. I hope we get that soon. Anyways, the good news is we could do a powered landing here. I'm not going to worry about it. I'm just going to ditch this stage like that. Goodbye, Lignova. I'm going to pop Lignova chute like that. And Lignova is going to go along his merry way and land in his capsule on his first successful mission to the moon. Let me do this. I need to give some shout-outs on the follows. I haven't been keeping up because I've got too many notifications going on. Who do we have? Deadliest Path, Vescola, Dark Res, Marty71, Horrible Gelatinous Blob. That's a cool name. Luke Daduk, Jackson with the follow, EM1 Epic, Vilnius, and Luke1023. Luke1023, why do I know that? What is 1023? Is that the default port for SQL Server? It's 1033. There was the explosion of the stage. Probably should have been watching that, I guess. 1033 is the default port for SQL Server. Back in the day, at least. Guys, thanks for the follows. You're watching Kerbal Boot Camp. We're teaching to play Kerbal Space Program. If you've never played it before, there's a free demo you can download. Somebody toss a demo link in there. If you want to get it, it's freaking $18 on sale right now. It's normally $30, and it's $18 right now. Which is really freaking cool. You should totally get it. Troll Russian. Welcome to stream, Troll Russian. I don't know how to talk like a Russian troll. And Mine Andy as well. Thank you for the fire. Pyro fire, what's shaking? Guys, we're doing Kerbal Space Academy. We're talking about the demo just now. You can download the demo for free and give it a try. In fact, tomorrow I'm going to be doing a little bit of a stream using the demo before I do KSA Help Desk. So maybe be on the lookout for that. If you don't have the game, it's on sale for $18. We're also doing giveaways over the course of boot camp. so you might win a copy. And here's the deal. Don't not buy it right now just because you think you might win it in a giveaway. If you really want to get it, giveaway or no, buy it right now. And if you win a giveaway, I will reimburse you for it. I will reimburse you for that cost of the game if you buy it on sale right now. Toss a sale link in there. Toss a KSP. Nice. Thank you, Infun, as well. There's Lignoba. Splashdown. That was really great timing. Like I said, don't not buy the game on sale just because of the giveaway. If you buy it and you win a giveaway, I will reimburse you for it. I will reimburse you for it. So, we are good to go. Lignoba has successfully returned. Let's do recover vessel, and we're going to take him back to the Space Center. And now we are going to look at building these rockets. We're going to look at how to build the rocket that had that mission right there. I am going to go into the VAB. Remember, I'm going to go into the VAB. That's where I build rockets. I just click on that building. And here we have the KSA Mooner Trainer Mark II. By the way, I really should have said this. I really flubbed up. I should have said this before I started this. If you want a copy of the Mooner Trainer Mark II, you can get you one. You can get you one. You really want to learn how to go to the moon? Sure. Absolutely, this is going to go. Absolutely, it's going to go. Steel 32. No, you have to go to the sale link. Mercenary Blue, you have to go to the sale link. You have to go to the sale link to get it. They just put it in the channel up there. So let's see here. We were going to do craft. If you want to get a copy of this craft, you can actually go to this link right here. You can download the KSA Mooner Trainer. I actually put all my things up there. I put all the craft that I build. Usually I put all the craft. Sometimes it takes a while to get them up there. But the Mooner Trainer is uploaded right there. The Mooner Trainer is uploaded, and you can get it for that much. I'm reading two things at once. You can download this craft right here, the Mooner Trainer. It's got more than enough Delta V to do whatever you need to do. Craft it is. So if you want, go on that link. I just put a link in, and there's like five parts from the channel because people click the link. You can totally see that happening. But you can download this, and you can fly your own Mooner missions. However, if you want to learn to build this rocket so that you can actually build other rockets, go to other cool and exciting places. Jackson, thank you so much. This will be uploaded to YouTube later if you want to catch up on it. And we are currently in about hour 2.5. We've been going for about 2.5 hours. So, thank you for hanging out, Jackson. It's good to have you here. And if you stay here, if you keep on idling or whatever, you will continue to earn those credits. Don't tell anybody. My first Mooner Sandcastle. Infun, I've never gotten the Mooner Sandcastle. I've never gotten the Mooner Sandcastle. That's an Easter egg with the Mooner Sandcastle there. That's awesome. Anyways, this is going to be uploaded to YouTube. Let us begin to talk about building this craft. And like I said, if you want that craft link right up there, you can download the Mooner Trainer Mark II. You can download all these things in. If you have questions on how to install these crafts in your game, come back to the channel and ask us, because we'll answer your questions for you. All right, Scarlet River, good deal. Wait, Scarlet River. What are you streaming today? What are you streaming? Are you in Space Engineers? Guys, Scarlet River is a streamer who does KSP sometimes. I follow Scarlet River. Scarlet River has helped me out with some stuff. In fact, Scar, we really need to talk about your bot. I saw the comment about the bot earlier. I saw your comment about the bot, and I would definitely like to talk to you more about that. I just got this one going because it was, quick to get going. But Scar, thank you for hanging out. I appreciate you being a part of the Academy. Get over there, do your own stream. Let me know what you're actually doing. But you should be good to go. Cordybo, what's up? Dark Slayer, hey Doss, I'm here. I'm here often, don't talk much, but I hope this helped me get to the moon and beyond. Dark Slayer, it will. We're going to build this rocket for you. And you will be able to get places. We got that. What is the minimum delta V to get to the moon? Photon Man, that's an excellent question. Photon Man, Das, what is the minimum delta V to get to the moon? You could actually look at that. Oh, that's on my notepad. What image is up right now? To get to the moon, you could actually use this right here. The KSP subway chart. Somebody type cheats and you'll get it. From Kerbin to low moon orbit is 4,500 plus 860 plus 210. So it's about 5,500 delta V to get from low Kerbin, or to get from landed on Kerbin to low moon orbit. About 5,500 meters per second of delta V. That is about how long. You can use this subway chart to calculate the delta V you need to get anywhere. From Kerbin to Minmus, from Kerbin to Moho, from Kerbin to Eve, from Eve to Elu. There's a lot of different stuff you can do there. I'll talk to Scar. He just started. Nice. Thank you. Thank you, Dakota John Ayers. I appreciate you. But to get up to the moon, it's about 5,500 if you're just going to get in orbit and not come home. So like a little satellite or something. If you need to come home, you're going to need to have it more than that. And we're going to talk about that in detail as we build this rocket. Let me see if I got anything else in the chat. Is chat scrolling? Yeah. Thank you, Arbrimmer. That's actually good. Help in the throat. I'm going to check my chat right quick. See if I missed any questions. All bad. Yes, it will go up on YouTube. Also, port 1023 is unused. Nice. Hey, DOS. What mods? Actually, right now, Thrustleet, I'm using Astronomer's Visual Pack. Astronomer's Visual Pack. I really need to upload the... update the mods down there. Let's see here. Just bought my buddy KSP. Dude, Godfather Bobo, thank you for that. You just bought your buddy KSP. Heck yeah. If either of y'all win, I'll reimburse you for that. I will reimburse you for buying that if either of y'all win one of the raffles today. Thank you for doing that, Godfather Bobo. That's awesome. That is absolutely awesome. Jeez. Heck yeah. Heck yeah. That's what we're trying to do right here. Okay. What am I doing? I got that. I've got that open. I've got that. There we go. Put that over there. That's good. Now we can minimize it down. Okay. What are Kerbits? I don't even know what Kerbit is. What is a Kerbit? I don't know. Not even the demo. In fun, we're your friends. And we'll try KSP. We're your friends and we will definitely try KSP. You already have KSP. That's hilarious, Cybertech. FL Kiwi, thank you again for the donation. I do appreciate you. Blue Bay, to re-answer your question, hey DOS, how do I prevent extremely high G-forces on re-entry? Come in very shallow. Very shallow, so that you have a very gentle arc coming around the planet. Come in very, very, very shallow. That's the best way to do that. Alright, good deal. Good deal. Did I miss anything else? You should teach with vac delta V, not atmo. You need the same delta V and atmo for every launch. The vacuum delta V is what varies per launch, so IMOR is more useful to learn. Yargnit, I'll think about that. I'll think about that. That's actually a good thing. I'd have to redo some of my stuff, so I won't do it today, but maybe it would be easier. Maybe it would be easier to do it that way. And then you just have to know what the vacuum delta V is. I don't know. I'll give that a thought. That's not a bad idea, Yargnit. Thank you. Talk to Scar. Okay, we saw that one. Bought your buddy KSP. That is amazing. Godfather Bobo. Kerbits, I don't know what you were asking about. Almost missed this. Gonna throw my phone out the window one of these days. Hey, DOS, Mono Bobby, you're here just in time. You probably already know how to install mods. We're getting ready to buy the, to do this Moonar rocket. Do this Moonar rocket. Build it. Talk about it. Banished and don't starve. Good deal. Give him a shout out anyways. That's fine. Should I eat chips and hummus now while playing KSP or should it while watching TV later? Oh my gosh. Alright. Okay. Can you tell something about how much delta V is required to get back? Can you read the delta V chart backwards? Arbrimmer, that is correct. You can in fact read the delta V chart backwards. However, there's one important thing. Aero braking. Helps you with a lot of that return delta V. So it's going to cost you, if you're in low moon orbit and you want to get away from the moon, it's going to cost you about 210 to get out of the moon's orbit. And it's going to cost you less than that to get back to Kerbin because you don't actually need all that aero braking. It doesn't cost you 860 to get back. So because we have inbound aero braking here, we don't actually need that 860. We just need to get into the atmosphere using 210 plus a little bit, right? Like 250 or 260, I think it is. And once we get into the atmosphere, the aero braking around this world makes this number obsolete, right? However, if you go out to Moho, there's no aero, there's no atmosphere at Moho, so you can't read it the same way. It actually costs you 1,400 to get down to the surface, 1,400 to get back up, 2,200 to circularize, 2,200 to get back out of its sphere of influence, because there's no aero braking with that. So, hope that answers your question. Cheeseburger, I'm not a machine. I'm just DOS Valdez. Should I eat... You should eat chips and hummus always. That actually makes me hungry a little bit. Wrecked. What did we wreck? Let's start building this rocket. Who's ready to build a rocket? You filled out the survey. Oh, thank you, Yargnit. Hey, Yargnit, By the way, I have the results of that survey. I've got hundreds of responses to it, and I'm more than happy to share that with you if you want to have a look at them. I'll do that after the stream, but remind me on Skype or something, and I will totally share with the results of the survey. It really is kind of illustrating in terms of what people are interested in with KSC or KSP. So remind me, and I'll share the results of that Google survey with you. Thanks for filling it out, by the way, too. My name is just Daspa. It's like the Valdez. That's all it is. That's the chart, Daspa. You're right. Ready to learn to build a moonship? Yeah. Did you eat all the pizza last night? I challenged you to find my entry. Oh, brother. Did I eat all the pizza last night? No, I didn't, but I think I'm going to get a fresh one. Because I'm going to have to go and da-da-da-da. Solar Weapon got a nice example of an Eve lander in Returncraft. Solar Weapon, we're going to do a stream where we do an Eve return mission one day. It's an advanced, that's definitely like a 900 level course, right? That's one of the hardest things to do in the game is to do a return mission from the surface of Eve. We are going to be streaming that. We are going to be streaming that. So, hint, Tylo. Oh, brother. Yarg entered potato where possible. That's awesome. What did Darkslayer? You don't have to raise your hand, Darkslayer. You can just say DOS or question. I don't know. What am I supposed to do? I can't call on you. Yes, Darkslayer. Your question is. Let's begin to build rockets. I'm going to click up here to get a new rocket. This gives me a nice blank VAB, right? A nice blank VAB. And in the blank VAB, I can begin building my rocket. Now, if you're playing in career mode, which I don't really recommend off the bat, if you're playing in career mode, you may not have as many parts of these. But since we're in sandbox mode, we have access to all the parts in the game. It makes it really easy to build these first rockets. What you want to do for your rocket, there are certain things that your rockets need. It's going to need some sort of command authority, some sort of command. So that can either be a computer to control it or a Kerbal who thinks he's flying the stick. So you need some sort of command. You're going to need fuel for the rocket. That's kind of a given. You're going to need some sort of fuel, some way to make the rocket go places. You're going to need an engine, something to actually use the fuel. Don't talk to me about Kraken drives or I will slap you. You're going to need an engine to get somewhere. Those are the three basic things you need on the rocket. It's as simple as that. So let's build an insanely simple rocket here. Let's get a command pod. This is the easiest command pod. Let us get a little bit of engine power here. And I see a lot of people doing things like this. Let's do that. Oh, that looks great. Yeah, all right, cool. And then let's pick an engine and put it on there, right? All right. That looks like a rocket. I mean, it seems to be like maybe a rocket. Infiniglider, jump off a cliff, Yarg. That looks like a rocket. I mean, it's got an engine, and it's got somebody flying it, and it's got that stuff. That's cool. Let's see here. Vessel type. Oh. Cybertech, thank you for reminding me of that. Ah, yes. Cybertech, thank you for reminding me of that. Where is my... There we go. Let me turn the keys off for now. Remind me to put them back on. All right. I wish I could drag those tabs around, but I know I can't in the VAB. I want to put it there because I'm just going to keep forgetting. I'm really just going to keep forgetting. You know it. So, there we go. That looks good for now. So I've got all the things, right? I've got a command pod. I've got some fuel. I've got an engine. I mean, this looks good, right? This looks good. Who wants to get in this rocket? I'm just going to do it. I'm just going to do it really quick. If you're participating in chat, you don't have to say anything because I've already done it. The person I'm going to put in this rocket is Mercenary Blue. That's what you get for talking in class. We're going to put you in this rocket, Mercenary Blue. Let's take it out to the launch pad. I'm going to do it unannounced like that, and it'll just be... Don't spam it in chat. It's already too late. You'll just have to be participating in chat, and that's how you get picked. So we've got this rocket. That's Jeb. That's not who we want. We actually want empty vessel. We want to go down to the crew roster. Let's take old Berman Kerman here and name them Mercenary Blue Kerman. Did I spell that right? I hope I did. Mercenary Blue. Yeah, Mercenary Blue. Already follows the channel, which I appreciate. Mercenary Blue Kerman, apply. Oh, bad. Really? Nope. Sorry. Mercenary Blue, let's put you in the craft. So empty. Wait, how do I do that? Transfer crew? No. Why can't I put Mercenary Blue in there? Oh, no, part selected. I see. Command pod. Ah, add a Kerbal. Now, crew roster. Mercenary Blue. Welcome to the rocket, Mercenary. we're going to use you for some testing here. Congratulations, you lost. So I said I need three things. I need somebody flying it, mercenaries or volunteer. Volunteer. You need fuel and you need an engine. So let's go to space. I'm going to go ahead and put the throttle all the way up. I'm going to press the space bar to light the engine. And apparently this rocket is not going anywhere. That's very interesting. Yargnet, if you get picked, I'm gonna talk to the mod creator. I'm gonna have them create a new version of the mod that has an anti-badass flag in it. And that's what I'm gonna flag you as. But this is a little weird. I mean, I've got a rocket. Is it the throttle? I don't know. Trolley McDosterson in the house. It's not going anywhere, even though I have all of the things that I said that I needed, right? It's just not doing anything. Why is this net rocket not going anywhere? Well, apparently it's really, really, really trying to lift off, but it can't lift off. What is happening here? What is happening is the fact that the engine that I put on this rocket, I just chose an engine and put it on there, right? The engine that I put on this rocket is not powerful enough to lift the rate of the rocket. That's a problem. If the engine is not powerful enough to lift the rocket, you are not going to space today. That's just the rules, that's how it turns out. So, what we have to do here is pick another engine that's powerful enough. How looking right now, it's already been answered, but how looking right now can I tell on the screen that this rocket is not going to take off? This thing right here, Kerbal Engineer thrust to weight, says that our thrust to weight ratio, that's what TWR stands for, thrust to weight ratio, is 0.58. 0.58. Nope. That's interesting. It just went up. I wonder why it went up. The thrust to weight ratio is 0.58. 0.59 now. 0.60 now. That's interesting. It keeps going up. The thrust to weight ratio is the ratio of thrust force that the rocket can put out, the rocket engine can put out, and the weight of the rocket, the weight of all the pods and engines and fuel and everything that you're carrying. As I sit here on the pad and burn this engine, what's happening? The thrust to weight is actually going up. Why is the thrust to weight going up? Because the mass is going down. Why is the mass going down? Because the way rockets work, in order to get acceleration from a rocket, you ignite the fuel and you throw it out the back. You basically just take the mass of the fuel and you throw it out the back as fast as you can by exploding it. And that is why every second, every millisecond, every nanosecond, whatever you want to call it, that I am burning fuel and trying to toss it out the back of the rocket, I am getting lighter. Because once I toss that fuel out the back of the rocket, I don't have to carry it anymore. It's gone. It's flying out the back. So we could sit here and we could burn this rocket for so long. So long. Some mercenary blues life and add some parachutes. Pale Rider, it's almost like we knew that this wasn't going to take off, right? It's almost like we knew that this was going to take off. But that's a good, that's a good thing there. So with the thrust to weight, we're burning the fuel. You can actually see the fuel going down. You see the fuel being used up. And as the fuel is used up, it's thrown out the back of the rocket. And our weight route goes down. Our thrust remains constant. That engine right there, look, you can right-click on it. You can see it's putting out 50 kilonewtons of thrust. It doesn't matter what a kilonewton is. It's just putting out 50-somethings, bagels worth of thrust or whatever. Who even cares? It's putting out some amount of thrust. The thrust stays constant, and the weight goes down because the fuel is being thrown out the end of the rocket. The good news is, as you use your fuel up, you'll be able to accelerate faster because you weigh less. So an engine that's not very powerful when you're full of fuel may be a lot more powerful when you're almost empty of fuel. In fact, it will be more powerful when you're empty of fuel. That is how thrust to weight works. The thrust of your engine stays constant unless I throttle it. See, I can actually use the throttle, right, to increase and decrease the thrust. And as I use that throttle to increase and decrease the thrust of the liquid fuel engine there, oops, let's switch to this one. Now I gotta zoom in, I guess. Let's move the nav ball down. There we go. As the liquid fuel engine thrust remains constant, the weight continues to go down. If we sit here for long enough, if we sit here until this number reads 0.86, 0.87, 0.88, 0.89, when this number gets to 1.00, that's going to mean that we have enough power in our rocket to counteract the force of gravity. on Kerbin, right? I know I'm beating this into the ground. Kerbin tries to accelerate. Look at this right here. Look at this. This is actually great. You see our acceleration increasing? It's trying to accelerating us. We're getting rid of fuel, and the amount of force, the amount of acceleration that that rocket is able to push forward, the thrust to weight is increasing. When this number, thrust to weight ratio, gets to 1.0, we'll know that our power of our rocket is equal to the gravity on the planet. And so we'll be able to say exactly what Kerbin's gravity is. 9.6, 9.7, 9.8, 9.78 it looked like. That was 1.0 thrust to weight, and now look what's happened. Now, after thrust to weight got over 1, we've burned enough fuel that this rocket is actually able to take off. So, I can throttle it down. Look, if my thrust to weight is 0.84, I don't go down anymore. If I throttle back up again, there you go. Got your back, mercenary. I can take back off again. If I throttle down, I can go back down again. No! 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 Live, mercenary blue! Thank you, mercenary blue, for giving your life in the name of science and learning. What you can see right there is that when we ran, when I had it throttled down enough that I went down and touched the pad, I actually tipped over, crashed. I was hoping Mercenary Boo would live, right? But we just fell over too far. Don't know what to tell you. Maybe we should posthumously. This is why you don't let trainees fly without SAS. Themology, or the Moogie. The Moogie. I appreciate that. Let's do this. At least we save the motor. At least we save the motor. Oh my gosh, dude. Hexic, welcome back. No, Mercenary Blue Kerman was killed while trying to demonstrate a very simple concept on the pad. Let's do this. Let's posthumously add 5 credits to Mercenary Blue. Mercenary Blue, there we go. Mercenary Blue, we salute your sacrifice. Have 5 curb. Have 5 credits. I'm actually going to revert it. It's all good. Flag ceremony. I think it'll take us too much time if we do flag ceremonies. Mercenary Blue was actually just killed in the simulator. Killed in the simulator. Luckily, we were in the simulator and Mercenary Blue didn't actually die. Let's just roll with that. So, we were talking about thrust to weight. We were looking. Look in Kerbal Engineer right here. Do you see Kerbal Engineer says that my thrust to weight right now is 0.49. I know, without even going out to the pad, that if I try to light this rocket on the pad, it is not going to take off. In order for this rocket to take off, I need, right there in Engineer, that thrust to weight to be over 1. So let's do some stuff. That's compensation to his family of his death. That's cheating. He's dead. He's not dead. He's not dead. He was in the simulator. Sorry, I forgot to tell you. So, until we get this thrust to weight over 1.0, this rocket is not going to take off. This is Das Valdez teaching you how to not fly safe. So let's do this. Let's look. I mean, I can click on the engines here, and I can drink. Way to go, chat, by the way. Okay. A viewer's life is worth 5 credits. Actually, dying in the simulator is worth 5 credits. I clicked on my propulsion tab. If you didn't notice, we're in Sandbox. We have all these different things. There are different tabs you can click off. This one here with the fire and the... I don't even know what that other thing is. The fire looks good. That looks like it should go to space. So what I can do, I can actually come down and hover over different engines. The one we had on there was this LV-909. And you can see right there that the thrust that an LV-909 puts out is 50 units, 50 kilonewtons, 50 units of thrust. I could look at this engine. That's terrible. That one only puts out 4 units of thrust. But check out what's cool. The thrust actually adds up. So if I were to take these engines and add them to the 909, watch my thrust to weight. My thrust to weight actually went up to 0.64. In fact, we could probably spam enough of these engines, 0.79. So we could just do this sort of deal. 1.07. So just by spamming those little engines, I could get this over 1.0 thrust to weight. And if we took this out of here is a fuel gauge. I guess that makes sense. A fuel gauge, boring. Should be an explosion. If I put additional engines on here, the thrust of each engine actually adds up. So we have, what, 8? 16 of these little engines putting out 4 thrust each, and one of these engines putting out 50 thrust. So that gets us enough thrust to get us over 1.7 thrust to weight. I'm not going to fly the rocket this way. This is a dumb way to do it, because what we can actually do is just shop around for another more different engine. So instead of the 909, I have a feeling that maybe this engine looks good. Yeah, seems legit. That totally seems legit. That thrust to weight is 9.65. Why is it 9.65? Wait a second. This one was 50. That engine right there, 1,500 thrust to weight. What is that? 30 times the thrust, right? We would need 30 times the thrust. We would need 30 of these engines to counteract or to get the same amount of thrust that this one engine, the mainsail, the Rocomax mainsail. I want a bumper sticker that says, my other car is a Rocomax or something. My other ride is a Rocomax. I would totally put that on my car. No one would have any clue as I was driving around, but if somebody came up to me at a stoplight and they're like, oh my gosh, I'd be like, yeah. Anyways, this is a mainsail liquid engine. It puts out 1,500 units of thrust. That's going to give us a 9.65 thrust to weight. Let's take this out and see how this goes. Let's take this out and see how this goes. Mercenary, I will go ahead and put that on there for you. Is he still in there? No. Do we have somebody named Mercenary? Oh, we reverted. Oh, I see. So you can't actually... That's actually really annoying that you can't do it right here. You can't rename him right here and then have it save. You can't revert the flight. All right, that's okay. I guess we're just going to have to choose another cadet. Another cadet. So I'm just going to go winner. I'm going to do it before I even say it. R2B Anime is the poor sucker who's going to go into this rocket. R2B Anime. Not me on this one. Hey, if you get pulled out of line, if you get pulled out of line, R2B, I put you a chute. If you get pulled out of the boot camp line, you're getting on the rocket, cadet. I need to not do that. Sorry. Let's go ahead and put R2B Anime in there. Empty vessel. I really need to do this fast. There we go. Crew roster. Berman. Let's go, R2B Anime. There you go. Apply. Uh-oh. No, not going to happen. We need to stop using Jeb. There you go. Let's do add. R2B Anime is now in the pod. Let's see how well R2B Anime does. We've got the crew roster. Let's get that mod out of the way. Now we have 9.06 thrust to weight. That seems good. Let's see if this rocket can take off. Oh, staging as well. Thank you. Staging as well. Khaleesi, thank you for that. Let's see if this rocket can take off. I'm going to go ahead and put the throttle full throttle. I'm going to put the panel out just so I can see it. R2B, you better hang on because you've got 100 meters per second of acceleration. That's what? That's almost 10 Gs. That's almost 10 Kerbin gravities. Let's go ahead and see if this rocket with 9.6 thrust to weight will take off. 3, 2, 1, space! It is definitely taking off. It seems to be taking off just fine. It's actually getting Mach effects there as it takes off. R2B looks a little bit concerned. He's like, I don't even know what is happening. I'm not flying anything. R2B's breaking through the cloud layer. We just ran out of fuel. Now we're slowing down again. That is interesting. Apparently, the engine that we put on here had so much thrust to weight, we went up very, very, very quickly. In fact, we went so quickly that we broke the sound barrier, it looked like. I didn't see what our max speed was. What was our max speed? 690, almost 700 meters per second. That is definitely above the sound barrier, isn't it? That's definitely above the sound barrier. Farewell, cruel world. R2B, I got your back. I'm not going to try to kill the Kerbals. I didn't mean to, in the simulator, kill kill the last Kerbal. But we are good to go. We went up. We are now falling back down again. That's interesting. And look at this. Up here at the top, it shows you your current altitude. That's your current altitude above sea level. It also shows you how quickly you're falling. So you see right there, we're falling pretty quickly. We're falling at more than 100 meters per second. That's Mach 2. Thank you. Nice, Blue. Appreciate you. You might have lost some fuel to drag. Solar weapon, just a little bit. Remember, this is boot camp. Mach 2. How did you get that status up on screen? What status? What status? Lost lots of Delta V due to drag. You're not even kidding, dude. A Black Welly and Ad Monster. Thank y'all both. Thank y'all both for the follows there. We're doing Kerbal Boot Camp. We're doing Kerbal Basics. Kerbal Basics. That's what you always say, Das, not killing Kerbals. Whatevs. Whatever, Rutnut. All right, R2B. Pull the handle that pops your chute. Let's see if we can save you. Let's go ahead and pull the handle that pops your chute. We're still going down. We're falling at the surface, 140 meters per second. We've popped the chute. This may end in disaster. It may not. We will find out. R2B Anime, thank you for your service. We continue to fall towards the planet. We've popped the chute. That engine had tons and tons of thrust away, right? We went up really fast. There the chute opened up. Trouble, we're still falling at 19 meters per second. I wonder what's going to happen. Even though the chute's open, we're still coming down at 18 meters per second now. 18.2 to be precise. R2B Anime, hold on. Hold on, this is going to be a little rough. That's cool. That's cool. That's cool. R2B Anime, perfectly fine. He looks a little concerned. But that right there was an excellent demonstration of ablative braking. We actually, now he's good. Look, he's smiling now. He's like, oh, I made it. Let me fix my helmet. That's exactly what we were looking for. I know he'll live. I know he will live. Like a boss. R2B Enemy, congratulations. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. Perfect lesson in litho braking. What happened? Not wrecked. What happened was that we had that big engine, we had those fuel tanks. That one little wonky chute was not enough to slow us safely, right? Let me go show you about that. The one little chute was not enough. However, the exploding parts underneath us slowed us down enough that he was able to land. Let's go back and look. Top, you're right, Yargnet. It's just like a professional implosion. The top falls down on the bottom as it explodes. Here's what we're going to do. Let's explain what just happened in there. That's another concept I wanted to explain. I am going to go ahead and recover R2B right there. Put him back in the VAB. And I should really do a Blue Mercenary as well. Can I use it out here? Configure visible buttons. Crew manifest. Will it let me? That click-through, though. Thanks, Unity. I want to go back outside. Let me see if I can just save Blue Mercenary so we can do a shout-out to everybody who got picked. There we go. Configure visible buttons. Crew manifest. Ah, you can't do it here either. This mod really needs some work, I think. I want to be able to edit Kerbals in this scene. Dude, Cowboy 9870, thanks for the follow. I appreciate you. What just happened? We had this rocket. It had tons of thrust away. It took off like a shot. You saw the Mach effects. It was going Mach 2, right? We went up. We went into the sky. We ran out of fuel. We fell back down. We popped the chute. And the chute did not slow us down enough. When we impacted the surface of Kerbin, we were actually going 18 meters per second or something like that. When I look at this mainsail, I can actually come over here back to the propulsion tab. I can hover over the mainsail, and I can see that the Rocomax mainsail liquid engine has a crash tolerance of 7.0 meters per second. 7.0. 18 meters per second, 7 meters per second. This part does not have a crash tolerance to survive that impact speed. So, what happened was when we hit the surface of Kerbin, going 18 meters per second, that engine exploded and blew up and, you know, blah, made that huge explosion, and we fell down. It went away. It completely explodes and disappears. After that engine exploded, we had, you remember the ground was like down here, right? Say that engine exploded. It blew up, went away. Then we had our pod on top of two tanks. The two tanks, we can go over, we can look at the tank. This tank has a crash tolerance of 6 meters per second. So apparently, that thing slowing us down was not enough to stop us. It exploded, then we had to fall this distance. And as we fell this distance right here, bam, we must have hit it more than 6 meters per second, because that tank exploded. Right here, let me do the sound effect. Boom! And then we fell that distance. That distance was actually further, right? After we fell this distance, that tank hit. I mean, if that shorter distance we fell was enough to explode the previous tank, this distance right here must have been greater than the crash tolerance, 6 meters per second, right? So this tank, Then the pod fell down that distance and landed on the ground. When the pod fell down, it hit at some number. However, look at the impact resistance of the pod, 14 meters per second. So when that pod fell down, it must have been going less than 14 meters per second. I didn't calculate. I've never done that exact thing before. Sorry, R2B. But when the pod fell down, it was going less than 14 meters per second, and so the pod did not explode. So that, in the game, every single part has a crash tolerance. You can see this thing right here, crash tolerance 6. This pod, 14. That pod, 50. These things down here, 45 meters per second. This thing, not so much, 8. Every part in the game, fuel tanks, this engine, 7. That tank, 6. I love the aero spikes, 20 meters per second. They make great landing gear. Every part in the game has a crash tolerance, and if you impact another object going more than that crash tolerance, you will explode that part. It'll slow you down a little bit, but that crash tolerance, if you exceed it, you will explode the part that you're looking at. Any questions on the thrust to weight or on the crash tolerance that I just demonstrated? I'm going to read chat right quick. Let me do this. Let me do a chat. Let me do chat beacon. Right like that. Alright, wait, what? Unknown command. Seriously? Me, chat beacon. There we go. Let me scroll back to the chat, see if there were any questions that came in while I was doing that, and I will answer all of those questions. Let's see here. Scrolling on up again. There's the winner. This is what the viewer's life is worth. Scrolling up. Ah, okay, there was a question. Let me see, I'll get to it. Cheeseburger. Hey, or no, Dave Ryder. Hey, Doss, in and out, but keep up the great stream. Thanks, Dave, I appreciate you. Cheeseburger, that must mean you're better than Max. Am I better than Max? I don't work for a squad. I guess you're talking about Max Maps. Max Maps is awesome. Max Maps is absolutely awesome. Infinite Glider, nice. Keys, we got that. Google Delta V map. Super Platypus, the best thing to Google if you want a copy of this thing right here, right? Show image. If you want a copy of this right here, Google KSP Subway, KSP Subway, or just type in my channel exclamation point cheats. Either way, you will get it good to go, and you will be able to download this thing, KSP Subway, if you want to Google it. Let's see here. What else did I have? They should have an item called Snack Pack. I love it. Talk in class, get sent to space atop a flaming pillar of metal and fuel. I love it, Petey. I love it. Let's see. All I gotta say is my Kerbal better have Yauke Yarg. Excuse me, what happens if it explodes? We just went over that, Jade. We just went over what... that's right. The question, what happens if it explodes? The part disappears, just like I demonstrated, and you will continue falling to the ground, or if you're in the part that explodes, you will die. That's... Headphones dead. And I'm back. All right, good deal. I was scrolling through the chat. Headphones died. Excuse me, all right, we got that one. I had a very low thrust to weight. Yep, forgot to hack gravity. Hurrah. Thrust to weight low, yes. How did you rename the Kerbal? Thrustleet, that is a mod called Crew Manifest. If you go to the forums, you go to that community mod post like I showed. The name of that mod to rename the Kerbal is Crew Manifest. He welded the engine to the pad. Landed on Tylo today. If I get picked, could I get the... No! Sorry, Moonchild. Sorry. How do you see those stats? What stats? Darkslayer, didn't understand the question there. How do you see those stats from Darkslayer? It goes up because you lose weight. Fuel, Arbor, you're exactly right. Can you teach us to read the Navball solar weapon? Absolutely. When I get you into orbit, I'm going to teach you how to read that Navball. I am going to teach you how to read that Navball. Jax 9 Hammer, Das, how do you open Kerbal Engineer on the flight stream? Jax 9 Hammer, on both the flight and the VAB and the spaceplane hangar screens, press the backslash button. It's right underneath the back, right above enter on the right-hand side of your keyboard, usually. Press the backslash button. I could actually do it right here. Let me hide this window. Nope, that's from another stream. If you press backslash, you can show and hide the KER window just like that. It is backslash. That was for Jax 9. Das, when you rebuild it, may I request to save Mercenary Blue's life and add some parachutes? Yes, Pale Rider. Thank you for looking out for Mercenary Blue. Is the moon inside Kerbin, Das? No, Blue. So, Das, as long as your thrust weight is above 1 and Delta V is in the high 4,000s, can you get anything into orbit? Blue, you are exactly correct. You're exactly correct. So, Das, as long as thrust weight is above 1 and the Delta V is high, you can get anything into orbit. Those are two numbers that are very important. I'm not going to say that your payload may be unbalanced and it'll fly no matter what and that sort of stuff. SA's Falcon, is that... SA's Falcon. Dude, hey, SA, what's up? Thank you for joining Kerbal Bootcamp. We're talking about the basics of Kerbal Space Program. Trying to show people that you can play Kerbal Space Program. It's absolutely amazing. A lot of fun. Yeah, Blue, those are the numbers that we look at, though. At least 1.0 to take off the pad. I'm going to teach you something a little bit different. And 4,000 plus Delta V. We'll show you what that means when we get to building more rockets. I want to measure my thrust in bagels. Is your mission molest town or font different? I don't think so. I'll check next time I go out, Yargnet. I don't know. I didn't change anything unless some mod did it. This is why you don't... I killed a student? Nope, it was in the simulator. Flag ceremony. Compensation of 5 credits. Teaching me how to lie. That's what it's worth. Yep, 5. Reading all the red things. Guys, if you're new to the stream, you can use the word DOS. You can use the word question. It'll highlight it in red in my chat. You can actually see it highlighted in red over there. And on occasion, just like I'm doing right now, I scroll back through the stream and I read the questions. I'll answer all the questions you have. Especially, I'll go in depth if it's about the topic I'm talking about right now. Ask any question, though, even if it's about nothing to do with it. I may not be able to answer it in depth right now, but I do get everything that's highlighted in red, and you can do that by saying the word DOS or saying the word question. Thank you, Gav. Thank you. Oh, we just did credits. Fuel gauge is the other thing. Ah, it was a fuel gauge. The other thing is a fuel gauge. Boring. There's a self-destruct mod. What? The tag is my car is a Rockamets and its engine is a mainsail. What do you think? I like it, Blue. I like it. Not me on this one. Crew, that's the best way to get a... Don't bring attention to yourself by saying not me. Stage, we fixed the chute. Arbrimmer, we demonstrated that chute was not going to be enough. On purpose. Shh. Mach 2, that's how fast we were going. You always say DOS, not killing Kerbals, whatevs. Getting the flag ready. He lived. A lot of people guessed it. Dude, solar weapon. Guessed that he would survive. I was hoping it would survive. I knew you were trouble when you walked in. I'm not singing that one, that's for sure. What else? Can we litho break on Jewel? Nope. There's not a lot of lith on Jewel, so it's very hard to break on it. R. Brimmer. Apparently all bad trust DOS. That's your first mistake. Because I will use you for good or for awesome. DOS. This is from Mona B. Mona Bobby, sorry. DOS, say that you are landing on an aerospike engine at just below the crash tolerance for speed, but the tank above the aerospike has a very low crash tolerance. Will the force of the impact destroy the tank above the aerospike? It will not, Monobi. It will not. It's really just the part that impacts the other part, not the part that's connected to the craft, right? There's a thing with the way the physics simulation works that says that a craft really can't collide with itself, so a part that's connected with another part won't really collide with itself most of the time, right? It's not supposed to be doing that, so it doesn't count that as a collision. It does impart the force, but a landing leg or an aerospike or something like that that has a higher crash tolerance that hits the ground first usually won't explode the parts connected to it. Now, you could hit so far that the connection expands and the other part actually bends down and hits the ground and explodes, but normally you would land on those aerospikes, you could have 20 meters per second. I wouldn't say you should land at 20 meters per second, but you know, you could actually break the aerospike off of the rest of the craft without destroying the aerospike if you landed too fast, because there's a difference between the crash tolerance and the connection strength. That is a possibility. Solar weapon, I will definitely get the nav ball for you, absolutely. Pop in, Heaven Capital Coastal Y on DOS's info. This is the first boot camp I've caught, and it's awesome. Dude, Vendelo, welcome. Vendelo coming over from Slimstream is where I usually see you. Thank you for hanging out. I appreciate you. Solar Weapon, thank you for following the boot camp, man. And plus, you've been here for a while. You've been here. I love it when people ask questions, and then eventually they follow. I really do like that. We lost DOS. Nope, a true professional. Thanks, Calvin. I do have ears. Don't tell anybody. The headphones, they're not like inductive headphones or anything. I do need an RTG. Needs to stream while pedaling a stationary bicycle that provides power. I would be in such good shape. A small solar panel array on top of my cap. Get some lead-lined pub nukes for your headphones. What? In your modded stream, what is your part organizer? In fun, it is called module manager? No, it's called add-on manager, I think. It's called add-on manager. I needed to do that. I needed to do that. But it's called add-on manager or something like that for the part. Wait, what is your part organizer? Oh, no, 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 you're talking about the part organizer. You're talking about the part organizer. Did I just miss this? Yeah, what is your part organizer? Okay. It isn't in your mod list. Let me get that for you right quick, in fun. Like I said, guys, this is boot camp. I answer questions. If you just want to see rockets explode, you want me to see launching missiles at the boot, at the buildings or something like that, that's not what I do in boot camp. We have lots of fun other times, but boot camp is really to answer questions and teach people the mechanics of the game. That is what we do at boot camp. So I really do appreciate people being patient while I answer these questions. That was in fun. Modded streams was my part organizer. The name of that part organizer in my modded stream is... Part catalog it is. Part catalog is the name of that. That was for InFun. Part catalog. You can find it on the forums for sure. Stationary orbit. Yes, a stationary orbit. I don't even know what that means. Das, does stats he mean the flight log window? Oh, if you meant the flight log window, I'll show you whenever we get back out there. Navball, peach and full IVA to the moon. That's hilarious, Yargnet. In Yargnet, you're right. 1.0 thrust to weight and 499 delta V may not get you to orbit because you'll waste too much. That's exactly right. We're going to go over that. Nightmare Invest, what's going on? There's the questions link. Theoretically possible that we can litho break form orbit. Yes! In Elydian, if you go to my YouTube channel, you can actually see a YouTube video of me doing a challenge, which is rescuing a Kerbal from orbit using no chutes, no engines, no control surfaces, only using litho breaking. So I got it done. I was able to rescue a Kerbal from orbit using only litho braking. No other way to slow down. Except for the atmospheric efficiency, right? But you can see that on YouTube. So maybe toss a YouTube link in there. Das, how do you get into boot camp? Step aside, Litz. You're already there. Boot camp's free. Anybody who shows up can join and participate. If you don't have the game, get the demo. It's on sale right now, too, if you want the full version. $18. It's a freaking steal. It's a freaking steal. Deadliest Path, Doth, I'm on mobile. If I win a copy of KSP, where do I get you on my Steam account? Deadliest Path, you may have to get onto an actual computer or something to send me a message. I'm not sure on mobile because you wouldn't have the messaging in the chat and stuff. We'll figure that out one thing at a time. We'll figure that out if we get there. AdMonster, Dov, Das, I love the stream, so maybe make a YouTube channel. How do you get the game? AdMonster, I'm going to answer that one right there. Dude, look at this. AdMonster, there's the free KSP demo that InFun did. It is on sale right now for $18. You can buy it right there via the Humble Bundle store. And what was the other question? I have a YouTube channel. There it is. Follow Das Valdez and KSA here on YouTube. So all three of those things. There's two ways to get the game. One for free on the demo. One for buy on the Humble Bundle sale right now. You should be good to go. And the last one, there's my YouTube channel. They just linked it. Gotcha, Das. Thanks. Add a decoupler to help out. Jade the Fox, that's not a bad idea. Kerbal, Das, and see how you like it. Dude, InFun, thank you for helping out. What lesson is coming up next? I really want to learn what those weird icons on the navball. In Elytian, we are going to get this rocket into orbit. We still have a little bit of building to do. We still have a little bit of building to do to explain Delta V and how we manage the Delta V on a rocket. But I will teach you what those things on the navball mean coming up after we build this rocket. One for purchase. Sometimes you gotta realize I say things just on purpose. It's pronounced Lighthouse. Oh, it's Lighthouse. Lieutenant House. I thought it was Lieutenant House. Sorry. One for purchase. I've caught up with the chat. Das Left Nut, what's going on? How you hanging? Me, Chat Beacon. No, I always do that backwards. Oh my gosh. Me, Chat Beacon. Much better. I guess either way would work, huh? But let us build more rockets. Let's build a rocket that can actually go into to go into this. There we go. Hit Parader? That's a really good question. Can anybody answer Hit Parader's question? I don't actually have it on Steam, but Hit Parader is asking if there's a way to fix an install if you bust it with mods. Somebody see if you can answer Hit Parader's, because I don't actually have it on Steam. His Ket program number. What does that mean, crew? What does that mean? I don't know what that means. Let's actually get this guy into space, and we're going to talk about another concept here, right? We talked about thrust to weight. We talked about crashing. We talked about impact resistance of the part. Let's talk about another thing. Prograde retrograde in the blue one. The direction of your maneuver. I have no idea what the other ones do. Intellion, I will introduce you to Angry Triangle coming up really quickly here. Angry Pink Triangle. You will learn exactly what Angry Pink Triangle is coming up in just a minute. Let me get this built, though. Yeah. Guys, let me drink just a little bit here. Sorry, responding to a message. Yark, dude, you're awesome. Thank you. Let us talk about building this rocket. We talked about thrust to weight. We talked about the impact tolerance, right? We need to build a rocket that can actually get us into orbit. So let's go ahead and add some, we've got control, we've got the chute. Let's add some fuel to this thing. I'm just going to toss that thing on there. Das is typing to show some of his keys. It does do that. So I've got some more fuel on there. Let's add, an engine to it. This looks good. Let's add some more fuel to it. Well, that's a problem. Apparently, not all parts in the game have the green glue on either side. Do you see the green glue there at the top of that piece? That green glue is what's called an attachment point. It's actually an axial attachment point because it's aligned along the center axis of the part, right? That axial attachment point is how we put the pieces together. See how whenever I grab that and I get the green glue there and I get the green glue there? What that means is whenever I put two pieces of green glue together, it'll actually stick. See how the part is red? I put the green together and it sticks. That means I can do that. This part here, see how it only has green glue on one side? When I put that part there, it has no more green glue to the bottom, so I can't actually attach that. That's a problem. Be on the lookout for that. Be on the lookout for how that green glue works with your parts. Let us just grab like one of these engines. And now we need to learn something new, right? Thank you for the key press thing there. Now we need to learn another concept here. We've talked about the attachment points, the green glue, I call it. I've got another fuel tank. I could put the other fuel tank right there. Seems legit, right? Who wants to get into this rocket? I put the fuel right there. I've got a fuel tank on the bottom of it. What do you think's going to happen if I light that engine and that fuel tank is there? Do you think it's going to automatically decouple? Do you think it's going to separate? Do you think that engine is just going to light? Let's find out. Who should I put in this rocket? Let's go to launch. I have too much fun doing this. I really do have too. Oh. I really do. Jeb's in there. I wonder who I should put in here. Let's see here. I'd put you in that rocket. Let's see here. The winner is Dan for Rescue. Congratulations, Dan for Rescue. You are going to go into this rocket here so that we can demonstrate what happens if an engine is pointing at a fuel tank. Demonstrating what happens if an engine is pointing into a fuel tank. There's Lignoba. There's Nedmul. Let's go ahead and get old Dan for Rescue Kerman in here. Apply. Command pod. Add you to the command pod. Dan for Rescue, are you here? Let's go! All right, I like the enthusiasm. Let's get this going here. I'm actually going to throttle this up. I am going to... Let's look at the panel. Okay, the panel is there. Let's light this engine and see what happens. Wait. Oh, let's actually do some staging first. I'll talk about that in a second as well. Let's light the engine. That's not looking good. We're not going anywhere. And apparently the engine is somehow... I can't actually look inside the rocket. The engine's lit. And it's basically just burning into that fuel tank. Huh. I wonder, is it using fuel out of there? It's apparently actually somehow using fuel out of that fuel tank and out of this fuel tank. And there we go! That's what we were looking for. What happened right there? Oops. What? I'll go with that. I'll go with that. Let's just let it ride. Look at this gravity turn. Apparently... How you doing, Dan? How you doing? Apparently, putting an engine pointing directly into a fuel tank is not the best of ideas. What did we observe, cadets? We observed that whenever we lit that engine that was pointing directly at a fuel tank, it actually burned for a while and then exploded. And when it exploded, the rocket took off. So we learned a lot of things from that experiment. Number one, we learned that if an engine is pointing against another part, like a fuel tank, it's actually going to block the thrust of it. The engine won't put out any thrust if it's got another part touching the bottom of it right like that, right? Another thing we learned is that rocket exhaust is hot and can make things explode. It may take a little while, but it can actually make things explode. That's a problem. Another thing we learned is that whenever we blew up that part underneath us, we actually could take off. The next thing we want to learn is that if old Dan for Rescue Here wants to live, we should probably open his parachute. Oh my gosh. I was trying to, like, out of the corner of my eye watch the altitude, but I didn't want to kill Dan. Dash shoots, they're yelling shoots. Totally trolled y'all. So, look at what's happening again. What did we learn last time? Our speed towards the surface is 10.5. The impact tolerance of this is probably not 10. Let's see what happens. When we hit the ground, I bet you that engine explodes. Boom! The pod explodes. We're good to go. Don't die, Dan. Excellent. And really, if we wanted to, we could actually roll Dan back to the KSC. Let's do that right quick. Dan, time for you to get home. It is time for you to get home, Dan. Anyways, Dan, thank you so much for volunteering. Hopefully you knew that I had your back. Dan made it home alive. Let's click on done, and we should be good to go. All right. Is eager to continue his astronaut career. So, back into the VAB. We learned that when the rocket exhaust goes directly against this fuel like this, that is a problem. We're not going to go anywhere. It's eventually going to explode. How do we prevent that in this game? The good news is we have a way to prevent it. We've got a part over here on the structural tab called the stack decoupler. There's a couple things called the stack decoupler. There's a couple different sizes of stack decouplers. What you can use a stack decoupler for is to decouple stacks. Now, honestly, that looks terrible. There are different sizes of stack decouplers. That's for bigger parts. Let's use this one. That is apparently for a smaller part. This one here, we're going to call it the Goldilocks stack decoupler because it's just right. Let's put that there. And when I put a stack decoupler in there, it gives me some functionality. The functionality that stack decoupler gives me, it's filled with explosives. They're controlled explosives and can actually be used to break two pieces apart. We can break two pieces apart. So whenever I activate that stack decoupler, it is going to get rid of that fuel tank on the bottom, blow us away from this, and then the engine will come out of that fairing right there, and we will continue to fly without blowing up things. So let's try that. Let's try that right quick. Let's put an LTV 30 on there. You see we've got 2.0 thrust to weight, so we are going to take off. We've got that stack decoupler in there. So whenever this engine runs out of fuel, we'll be able to activate this next engine. We'll see. We'll explain how it's going to eat the fuel here. But let's take this out to the pad. Launch it. And this person is going to be... Solar Weapon! New to the stream, Solar Weapon. I know you just followed. You're about to get in this rocket, Solar Weapon. You are about to get in this rocket, Solar Weapon. Controlled explosives, right? Let's get Jeb out of there. I really wish there was a better way to do this. But let's go crew roster. Let's get... We're actually going to start hiring more people. Solar Weapon Kerman. Apply. Solar Weapon Kerman. I'm going to put you in. Let's empty vessel, command pod, solar weapon, add. Let us use you. Oops, that was engineer. Let us see how this works with you so that we can get it done. Now, I said... Ooh, that's a good idea. I said that I get some more functionality. I said that I can activate this decoupler, right? I can activate it. Das, how do you activate it? You can activate it. Add mercenary in while you're here. I don't know what that means. What we do here, we can actually activate this. There are a couple different ways to activate it. One way is to actually right-click on it and just press decouple. However, if I do that right now, the top part of the rocket is going to fall off the bottom part of the rocket. That's not what we want. That's not what we want. So, what we've got there, you could actually right-click on it and decouple it. Another thing we can do, we can press spacebar to activate what's called a stage. Remember, this is Kerbal Boot Camp. I'm acting like you've never played the game before. We can press spacebar to activate a stage. And what that means, a stage is a collection of parts that do something when you press spacebar. So right now, let's look at the staging. It's over here on the left side of the screen. You see it over here. We've got three stages in the rocket. The stages are actually red from the bottom to the top. And this right here, stage two, is the first stage that's going to fire. The stage down here at the bottom is the first thing that's going to happen. When I press spacebar, for the first time, it is going to launch this rocket. Let's do a demonstration here. When I press spacebar for the first time, it is going to launch this rocket. So we had greater than 1.0 thrust to weight. Let's actually throttle it up some. And we are going to be able to fly up. As we're doing this, we've activated it. Did you see? When I pressed the spacebar, it activated just the things that were down here at the bottom of the list. That engine right there is activated. Do you see how I can point at the engine? It says Oler Kerman. When I point at the engine, you see it highlight right there. And when I point at that, do you see it highlight the engine? You can see that that engine that I just lit is the engine that is in that stage going back and forth. So, yeah, we are. We are definitely going to get to Kerbal Engineer. We are going to get to Kerbal Engineer when we talked about the launch profile. We've got that. You can see right there that staging. When I press space the first time, that stage happens. Look at the next stage. The next time I press spacebar, what's going to happen? When I press spacebar, look at the part. That stack decoupler right there, you can see the stack decoupler is the next stage, right? When I press spacebar, we are going to go. There's a problem, though, because look at this stage. The next time I press spacebar, what's going to happen? It's going to blow. There are that decoupled. See how the engine came out of there when I pressed stage? We lost that decoupler. Also, notice the decoupler stayed on this part. That red triangle is important for that. I'll show you in the VAB. When we press space, we actually got that part to separate just like that. But look at this problem we've got. Right now we have a problem because the next time I press stage, spacebar, not only is the engine going to turn on, the chute's also going to turn on. We don't want that to happen. What we need to do is take this engine, drag it down into a different stage, and then when it is in two different stages, see if we can press spacebar. Nope, that didn't activate it. Oh, the bug! That's... Yargnit, get them to fix that. I'm trying to demonstrate staging, and the bug in the game breaks it. I knew it was going to happen, too. What you just witnessed was a bug in the game, right? There is definitely fuel in here. There was a stage down there, and I dragged that into another stage. But the problem is, I'm going to call it a bug, Yargnit, even if it's intentionally that way. There was a stage there. I had a deactivated engine into it. I dragged the engine down into that stage. When I pressed spacebar, the engine didn't actually activate. The problem is, if you've already done a stage, and you have an empty stage down at the bottom like that, and you drag a deactivated engine into it, it gets skipped. It thinks that since it's in that stage, which has already been activated, that the engine doesn't need to be activated again. And so it skipped that engine and didn't actually activate it. I should have fixed it the right way. But maybe we'll fix it the right way again. I dragged that engine down to that stage. Because of the way the game works, it thought that stage was already spent, and it didn't actually activate the engine for me, which was what I needed. Now, luckily... That didn't sound good. What is that part on the ground? Is that a stack decoupler? Did that stack decoupler bounce? Tell me it bounced and this is going to explode again. Let's watch. You ready to land down there in that explosive debris? I guess since the bug happened, or the feature happened, or whatever, I can demonstrate something else. I'm coming down at 14 meters per second. Good news is I have an engine. I can't do anything with it. I couldn't stage it. Nothing I could do could get that stage. I would have had to right-click it and do it. Yargnet, the fact that an empty stage appears at the bottom, I would say is a bug. I would say that an empty stage appearing at the bottom after a vehicle has been staged is a bug. That's what I would say. Because it's very confusing to new players, I really think that it needs to be fixed. Let's go ahead and put Solar Weapon back onto the launch pad. Revert to launch. We learned something. We learned that our staging was incorrect. We learned that there's a issue with the game where I dragged that down to a stage that was appearing even though it didn't have anything in it. That stage should have disappeared, and the game should have made me make a new stage, but for some reason it kept an empty stage there. What I want to do... Yargnet, it's a bug because it's not intuitive for new players. What I want to do is, while I'm on the pad here, click the plus sign to make a new stage, drag the engine down there like that, and because I did it before I launched the rocket, that right there will work correctly, as opposed to last time where I had what looked like an empty stage in there. I tried to drag an engine to it, and it didn't work. It skipped it. So that is definitely a problem. Let's try this again. Jeb is in there again. Let's just toss Solar Weapon in right quick. Crew roster, Solar Weapon, I'm going to use you again. Oh, that's so annoying. Solar Weapon, Kerbin, apply. Add you to the pod. Let's do this again. 3, 2, 1. Let's just go ahead and throttle up. Let's launch this. But now I've fixed this on the launch pad before I've activated any stages. There is a way we can fix it in flight, but it's best to check your stages before you actually launch. So now I've got an engine. I've got this thing. I've got an engine. And I've got the space bar. So the first space will do this. The second space will do that. The third space will do that. And the fourth space will do that. That looks good. That looks good. It was like this. Yarg. That's how it went without that there. It was like that right there. And whenever we decouple this, this stage remained attached to the rocket, even though there was nothing left in the stage. There were no parts left in the stage. It decoupled that and it left an empty stage like that. That's what happened right there. But to fix it on the pad, just create a new stage. You see how I did that? I could also remove a stage. Create a new stage. Drag your part down there. Now the first space will do that. The second space will do that. The third space will do that. And the fourth space will do that. So 3, 2, 1. Space. Thrust lead. Exclamation point craft. We're going to go up. We're going to burn the fuel out of this rocket. The first time I press spacebar. Excuse me. The first time I press spacebar, it lit the engine. The second time I press spacebar, it's going to decouple that stage. Fire the explosive bolts in there or whatever. The third time I pressed it, it's going to activate that engine. And the fourth time I press it, it's going to pop the chute. Let's see how that works. Better or worse to put the decouple and the new motor in the same stage? Lieutenant Haas, you are correct. We can in fact do that. I'm going to demonstrate that when I get back down to the VAB. It all comes down to whether or not your exhaust from your next stage is going to hurt the previous stage. So we're going straight up. When this engine runs out, I'm going to press spacebar for the first time. Like this. That's going to decouple me. You see how I got a little bit of a push from that? The explosive bolts do actually push you away a little bit. Now we've got some way to do that. We've actually got some distance. So the next thing I want to do is press spacebar again. And that lights that engine. Let's actually turn a little bit. Try to fly like a real rocket like you see on TV, right? That, I mean, anytime your exhaust plume is longer than your craft, you may be using an engine that's too powerful. But I'm going to fly right like this and see what we can do. Remember, I need to start missing the planet, so maybe turning this way will allow me to miss the planet. We'll get to that. So I'm flying like this. I'm just flying along, burning my rocket, and I don't know, this looks like how rockets get to orbit, right? Why don't I just, like, do this, and maybe this is how I get to orbit, I don't know. Apparently I'm out of fuel. Well, that looks like a problem. I wonder if I got into orbit, y'all. I totally thought that was going to work. I wonder if I got into orbit. Let's look here. Ooh. So we got a nice trajectory. We got a nice trajectory. This is a ballistic trajectory now because we don't have no way to control it anymore. But it's not an orbit. We are going to fly up at that angle, just like that, until we get to the highest point. That apoaps right there, AP stands for apoapsis. A lot of people just say apoaps, right? But AP stands for apoapsis. It could also stands for apokee, the highest point you are above Kerbin, I guess you could say. Some people like that. But that is the highest point in that arc. You see how that's the top of it. The apoapsis is the point where the vertical momentum I have from burning my fuel to thrust my rocket up is overcome by the pull of gravity. So it's going to take... Gravity's pulling on me right now. It's like trying to bring me back down. That's why that orbit's bending like that. Because I had X amount of momentum going up, and gravity is pulling me back down. And the more time gravity has to work, the more it bends me. The more it bends me, the more you see that orbit bend. When I get to the top, that is the point where gravity wins the fight and starts to pull you back down towards the planet. You can also see it from over here. Look, you see this gauge up at the top? The vertical speed gauge, vert speed, right up there at the top. You can see right now we are increasing our height at more than 100 meters per second. You can even look at it right there. You see that height increasing. Let's watch what happens here. As I go up, as I get closer to that apoapsis, the highest point in that trajectory, the point where gravity wins the fight and removes all of my vertical speed, right? All of my vertical speed, you will start to see this gauge go down. Let me actually turn that off. Do you see the gauge moving? You can see it moving very slowly. We're still going up, though. But that gauge is very slowly starting to decrease. Actually, if you look at this, it looks like we're going a little bit slower, too, right? That gauge right there is telling me if I've reached the high point in my orbit yet. We're just going to sit here and watch it. In fact, I'm going to check chat. Let's check chat. While it goes, and watch that gauge. It'll stay there. Watch that gauge. What happens? Dude, Creeperface, Jason DeGraff, and it's Brian505, New Mexico? Welcome to Kerbal Space Academy. Good to have you here. Alright. Okay. Oh! What just happened? Did you see it switch? Now we're going down. We just barely passed the apoaps. So that apoaps was a while ago. It doesn't say T plus. But now we're falling down. We didn't have enough energy to go way out in orbit. We didn't have enough energy to go to the sun. We went up. Gravity eventually lost, or gravity eventually won the fight and started to pull us back down towards the planet. So, we are now falling down at over 100 meters per second. We're decreasing that. Let's go ahead and get this done quicker. How you doing, Solar Kerman, by the way? I time warped a little bit. Now we're falling down this way. I wonder if you're going to land on that island. Wouldn't that be cool? That would actually be really cool if you land right there on that island. I totally didn't mean for that to happen. I didn't have time to do it. It looks like we're talking about the difference between apogee and apogee. It's apogee because G, right? Earth, Gaia sort of deal. I forget. Geo, I think it is. Not Gaia. That's dumb. Yes. But we say Apple Key because it's the highest point above Kerbin. You could do Apple Moon if you wanted to. That's a whole religious debate. It's a whole religious debate there. Anyways. Webboard, what are you looking for? Webboard, I will definitely get caught up with the chat questions. I will get caught up with it. Wait a second. WB Hokey, it's more like Mr. Pibb than Coke. Jump off a cliff, Hokey. Seriously? Doomsday Warrior, welcome to Kerbal Bootcamp. Teaching people how to play Kerbal Space Program. It's really awesome. Here's old Solar Weapon. We're coming back in. We're not coming in too fast. We're going a kilometer per second. Here's that atmospheric heating again, right? Fezzy. Kerbin is the planet and Kerbal is the sun analog. That's what I used to call it, and somebody proved me wrong. Somebody absolutely proved me wrong. I used to call it Kerbal, the name of the star in the center of the Kerbin system. Kerbal, what it actually is, we can look at it. It's actually just called Sun, which is actually kind of disappointing. I prefer my Dew, nice. So I'll actually go and show you after we get Solar Weapon here safely into the ocean, it looks like. Kerbin and Kerbal, got it. That's not actually what it's called. There we go. Now we're just going to go ahead and time warp. And we are going to float down to the surface of the planet. I opened the chute super high. I am hoping that the planet rotates underneath me. so that we actually land on the shore instead of the water. Either way, solar weapon, you'll be fine. Don't worry about it. It's Kerbal. The devs just refused to officially recognize it as that. That's awesome. Hey, Dr. Pepper fan. Closer to Mr. Pibb than Coke. I'll buy that. Okay, it's more like Mr. Pibb than Coke. I guess I'll go with that. Sundhog, what's going on? Sundhog, what's going on? I can't swim! No! You should have told us that beforehand, Solar Weapon. You spent more time in the tank. Let's watch how this works here.